Good morning, students. Welcome to the 13th part of the chapter, Coordinate Geometry. Here we are going to discuss area of a triangle using Heron's formula. Before going to Heron's formula, let us revise the concept of area once again. Here we have actually drawn four closed figures. Now, whenever you have a closed figure on a plane, its boundary surrounds some region. This region surrounded by this closed figure is called its area. So, area is basically the region surrounded by a closed figure on a plane. So, basically, this area is calculated by using or counting the number of square units inside that boundary. For example, you take the case of this rectangle. Here, you count the number of squares inside this region. Excuse me. So, here actually there are 18 squares, so we can say that area of this rectangle is 18 square units. Similarly, by counting the number of squares inside that particular region, you can tell what is area in square units. Of course, you know the formulas for calculation of area of a rectangle, area of a square. For example, area of a rectangle is length into breadth, and area of a square is a side into side or side square, and area of a circle is pi r square. We all know these formulas, and the topic here we are going to discuss is calculation of area of a triangle. We actually know the formula for calculation of area. What is the formula for calculation of area of a triangle? Yes, it's exactly. So, it's actually half base into height. So, this is the formula we use in general to calculate the area of a triangle when you know the base of a triangle and its height also. Basically, height is a perpendicular drawn onto a side from the opposite vertex. So, you take, here I have taken the side AB as the base. Now, you have to draw the perpendicular from C onto AB. Then, you measure the length of this perpendicular, that will become the height. So, here AB is taken as the base and CD is the height. So, actually this becomes 1 by 2 into AB into CD. So, by substituting the values of base and height, you can actually calculate the area of this triangle ABC. But here we are going to discuss one important topic: to calculate the area of a triangle when you have the lengths of the three sides. Formula for calculating the area of a triangle when you have the lengths of the three sides was given by a great mathematician named Heron. He is actually pronounced as Heron, or sometimes he is pronounced as Hero also. So he was sometimes called, he is sometimes called Hero of Alexandria. He was a great mathematician and engineer. He actually gave a formula for calculating the area of a triangle if you know the lengths of the three sides. So, this is the specialty of this formula. You need not know the heights drawn to the sides from the opposite vertices. If you have only the lengths of the sides, you still can calculate the area of this triangle. Before going to the formula, just let us have some important terms related to this triangle. As you know, AB, BC and CA are the sides of this triangle. We have some other notation to represent the sides here. For example, to take the case of the side BC. Now, what is a vertex which is opposite to BC? It is A. So, we can write the side BC using small letter A also. Let us take the case of another side CA. What is the vertex opposite to CA? It is B. So, you can represent the side CA by the small letter B. Now you tell me what is the letter that which we can use to represent the side AB? Very good. It's actually C, because to the side AB the opposite vertex is C. So you can represent the side AB with C also. Generally we represent the line segments using the end points. Here in the case of this triangle, we can represent the sides of the triangle using only one letter, which is the opposite vertex of the side. For example, if you take the case of AB, the opposite vertex is C. So, you can write it as small letter C and so on. So, using these three values, he has given formula to calculate the area of a triangle, which is square root over S of S minus A of S minus B of S minus C. You are wondering what is this S. You have here A, B and C. And here we have taken the help of another extra letter S, which is actually calculated by using the formula A plus B plus C divided by 2. Don't worry about it. It's very simple. You have to find the three sum of the three sides. Actually, if you add the three lengths of the boundary, you have it as a perimeter. So actually, I am taking half of the perimeter. So that is why this is called semi-perimeter. Just like half of a circle is semicircle, here I am taking half of the perimeter. So S is actually semi-perimeter of the triangle. So this was a formula given by Mr. Heron of Alexandria. You can understand this much better by solving an example here. So here the concept is calculate the area of a triangle whose lengths of the sides are 3 cm, 4 cm and 5 cm. So you have to take them as A, B and C, small a, small b, small c. Can you tell me what is actually small a here? Very good, it is BC. Small b is CA and small c is AB. You have to keep that in your mind. Now what is the first thing you have to calculate to find the area? You have to calculate the semi-perimeter S. A plus B plus C divided by 2, which is 3 plus 5 plus 4 divided by 2. Add the 3 values. You have 12. So 12 by 2 is 6. So half of 12 is 6. So simple. In formula, it may look a little hard, but when you solve it, it's very simple and easy. So add the 3 sides and make it half. That's all. So you will have semi-perimeter. Now let us take the area, which is square root over S of S minus A of S minus B of S minus C. Actually, you have a lengthy derivation of this formula. I am not going to derive the formula now because I have limited this topic only to application of this formula. Now we have to substitute the values of A, B, C and recently found the value S. So then you will have 6 of 6 minus 3 of 6 minus 5 of 6 minus 4. So as you know, 6 minus 3 will be 3, 6 minus 5 is 1 and 6 minus 4 is 2. Let us write the values here. If you observe, I have written the areas as square centimeter, not centimeter. Just previously I have explained you why this is square units. Right? Area is always measured in square units only. Now if you multiply all these values, you have 36 and you know square root of 36 is 6. So area of the triangle ABC is 6 square centimeter, as simple as that. So this was a formula given by who? Heron. So that's why this is called Heron's formula. Now the concept here we are going to discuss is how can we apply this formula in case of coordinate geometry. In coordinate geometry, you will be given only the vertices of the triangle. Then you find the area of the triangle using the vertices only. Now here we have to apply the previous knowledge, which is calculation of lengths of the sides. What is the formula we have to use? Yes, we have to use distance formula here. So by using the distance formula, first you have to calculate length of the side AB, BC and CA. That's the first thing you have to do. So calculate the lengths of the sides AB, BC and CA. Actually, how do we write AB using a small letter? It is actually C. BC is A and CA is B. So then take these values as C, A and B respectively. Then what is it you have to find? Very good. You have to calculate the value of semi-perimeter. Calculate the value of semi-perimeter. What's the formula for S? A plus B plus C divided by 2. Then after you calculate the value of the semi-perimeter, you have to find area using Heron's formula. That is how you can find the area of a triangle when the three vertices are given. So these are the steps you have to follow. Keep these steps in your mind. Right? We'll solve an example here. Then you can understand this better. So find the area of a triangle joined by these three line segments. So what's the first thing you have to do? You have to find lengths of the sides. So we have to find the lengths of the sides AB, BC and CA. So length of the side, to calculate the length of the side, we'll take A and B. And the formula, as you know, this very old formula we have used. I am not going to concentrate on this calculation because you know the calculations very well. So we got AB as root 36, which is 6. If you observe these two points, actually these two have their y coordinates same. So if two points have their y coordinates equal, then what's the formula you can use? Actually, you can use it as modulus of x2 minus x1 also here to to calculate the length of the side AB. So strengthen the concept of using this formula only. I have solved like this, right? Now let us take the case of BC. Here B is 81 and C is 29. Once again, you will make use of this formula. Here I got BC as 10, which is actually I got square root of 100, which is 10. Now let us calculate this length of the side CA. So this is the formula once again. C will be x1 y1 and A will be x2 y2. Then I got square root of 64, which is 8. Here, if you observe, the x coordinates are equal. Then if you find the difference of the y coordinates, you can get this length of the side. So actually you can use modulus of y2 minus y1 here to find the distance. For your centering the concept only, I have used this. But in general, when the coordinates are different, you can use this formula. That's why I have solved using this formula only. Then after calculating the sides, we have to take the values as A actually is BC. So A is 10, AB is actually C, and CA is B. That is how you have to take. But you cannot take AB as A, BC as B. You should not take like that. You have A is only CA, I mean BC, B is CA and C is AB. Then we find out the semi perimeter. I have got here S as 12. Then let us take the case of the area. Let us substitute the values. I have got square root of 576 and the root of 576 is actually 24. So here the area of the triangle is 24 square units. This is how you can use Heron's formula to calculate area of the triangle when the three vertices are given. First you find the lengths of the sides, take them as small a, small b and small c, then find the semi perimeter, which is a plus b plus c by 2, then calculate the area by using this square root of s of s minus a of s minus b of s minus c. So this is the formula you have to make use when you calculate the area of triangle. So this is the formula we have to make use of to calculate area when the three vertices of the triangle are given. So take this assignment. Here I have given two problems. In the first problem, I have given the lengths of the sides. So that is, I have directly given ABC, small a, small b and small c. You can directly use the formula here. And here in the second one, I have given the vertices. So here you have to find AB, BC and CA. Then you have to make use of this formula. This is a very, very important formula. You have a very high chance of getting this problem in your final exam. So solve this and you post the answers to me. This, remember, this is a very, very important formula. Name, remember the name is Heron. So Heron's formula is very, very important. Solve these problems and post it to me. Thank you.